today's tutorial, we're going to be taking this basic concept and turn it into the Dallas Stars hockey jersey. Hello there, Ali here from Sports Templates, and today I'm bringing you guys a new hockey template featuring the Adidas Adizero new hockey jersey that's going to be used in 2019-2020 season. This template comes fully featured with every possible customization of the jersey, including the collars and the rounded shoulders. So it comes with the main collar. If you zoom in, you can take a look at it. This is the main collar design, and then you can turn on the laces collar, the laces crossed collar, and the straight laces collar. Each one of these colors comes with its own extra details, and so you can see for this straight laces one, you can see the how it adds this extra shadow on top of the jersey, but when you turn it off, the extra shadows goes away with it. Also, we've added the rounded shoulders, so the design kind of go all the way. The shoulder design goes a little bit around the sleeve to do this rounded design edge. It's also featuring this fabric style with the dotted reflective circles. We tried to copy exactly the exact same look in terms of the textures. So we have this classic jersey texture here, and then towards the middle of the jersey we have a more fine texture. Then for the sleeves we have this regular fabric texture, and then when you want to add patches, they're gonna have their own layer, so they're gonna have a different look and reflectivity from the actual jersey fabric. The same goes for the C here and the main logo here. All these features are going to be present in all the files available on this template. So we have the back view, we have the three quarters view facing right, and the three quarters view facing left. They all have the extra shoulders, the laces, the crossed one, and the straight laces collars as well. And of course, all of them come with the dynamic lighting feature, so you can change the lights around your concept and make it fit whatever design you're working on. In today's tutorial, we're going to be taking this basic concept and turn it into the Dallas Stars hockey jersey. So to get started, I'm going to be using this design library. I'm going to be sharing it with you guys. You're going to have a link of the library in the description below, so you can follow along with every step I do. We have the colors and the graphics and the extra text that's going to go on the jersey. I've also found this image of it so we can use it for reference. So to get started, let's go to the main jersey editable parts. This is where we're going to change the colors of the main parts of the jersey. So we can get started with the torso. We can go to the base shirt design. You can open it up and see how we can do it. So on this layer, I'm only going to do the colors, as I'm going to leave the logos to the embossed logo graphics so they can look as if they are patches on top of the jersey. So if we go here, we'll try to copy this design with the stripes. So let's do a big rectangle about this big, and then let's run a small line inside of it. The line should be this dark color, and the big rectangle should be this off-white color. Let's push this down a little bit, something like this. Then let's hide this grid, pick the background color, and make it green. Let's save and see how we did. Seems like we need to push it a little bit lower, so we can just go here, Control T to transform, and let's push it down a little bit like this. Same goes for this one. Let's make it a little bit thinner, then push it down a little bit. Let's save. That looks closer to it. So now we can move on to changing other parts of the jersey. So the front color, the sides here, the back of the jersey. We don't need to add a design here, so we can just make it green as well. It's gonna look a little bit dark because of the shadows, but you can push that green up a little bit just to add some more details in the shadows. Now we're done with the torso. Let's move to the sleeves. The sleeves are basically the same idea. Double click to open the smart object. And we're just gonna try to copy this design. Let's do white rectangle like this and a smaller one inside of it. Make the smaller one black. And then I'm gonna add this number 14 here. So, right, and let's make it bigger and let's make it white. Let's drop these lines a little bit, hide the grid and make the background color green. And let's see how we did. Oh, that's the right sleeve. So we can, so we just need to push number 14 all the way to here. It's gonna be just showing the four because it's a rounded object. All right, it's close to the rounded shoulder here, so we need to push it down a little bit. Control S to save. Now we need to be doing the same thing for the other sleeve, and since it's gonna be pretty similar, we can just grab these design elements and just shift and drag so they can be in the same exact place. Let's hide the grid, make the background green, and just move the 14 all the way to the other side. It's gonna show a little bit of the 4 and the whole of the 1. Let's save it. So it's gonna look something like this. And that's pretty much it for the sleeves. Moving on, we can do the shoulders. We're not gonna be doing these shoulders because we already have the rounded shoulders turned on at the top. We can just make sure that everything here looks green so we don't have any issues with it. Now let's go to the collar. Let's zoom in. And so with the collar, we have black here with white and a black rim, as well as a black interior in here. We also have the labeling and the information from Adidas, as well as the Climelight logo is in here. Well, I've already added this template already comes with some basic measurements and tag information here. So if you double click, you can just hide the grid and make the background dark, then save it. And for the tooth size of the collar, we can double click here, hide the grid and make it white, then do the same thing for this side. Now let's click the front part and grab, let's make it smaller. And hide the grid and background. Let's see how it looks here. Looks good. So we just need to make this plate dark, this dark color, then coat the color edge and click this dark color. Now what's left is the back of the collar. So we just click it here and pick this same color as well. For here we have the Victory Green logo, so we can just grab it from the library and place it here. All right, if you want to add some more realism to it, you can just Control T to transform, then go to warp and just drag it down a little bit like that to give it the illusion that it's kind of going with the flow of the fabric. Then we can grab this Climelight logo and make it small, kind of like this. And that should be it for the collar. Moving on, we can go to the rounded shoulders. So we can go to editable parts right here. Make sure all the parts down there are green, just so we don't have any issues with the different layers. Then go to the right shoulder, bring this rounded Dallas Stars logo, Control T, and then rotate it to face the left. Make it smaller and let's put it about 3 boxes off the edge, somewhere around here. Let's put it under the levels layer and then hide grid and background color. Control S to save. Let's see how it is. That looks good, but I think it needs to be a little bit bigger. So we can make it a little bit bigger. Looks good. It's just like here. It's on the shoulder, but it's kind of going towards the rounded shoulder edge here. The same thing needs to be done on the other side. We can just basically make sure we have the same size. We can just open the first shoulder, shift and drag. Then control T and rotate to face the other side. Then drag it around three boxes off the edge. Hide the layers under it and let's see how we did. Looks good. Now what's left is adding the main logo here to make it like an embossed logo or like a badge that goes on top of the fabric. So let's go to embossed logo graphics and we go all the way down to the layer with the purple shade here, double click, and we drag the Dallas Stars logo and let's put it somewhere around here. Hide your logo placeholder and let's save and see how we did. All right, this looks a little bit too big, so we need to make it a little bit smaller, something like this. Control S to save. That looks better. If you zoom in, you can see how the logo looks like it's going on top of the jersey. If you want this logo to look like it's screen printed, you can just double click to open this layer, then go all the way down to torso where we started, double click here, then click the logo and drag here and save. Then if you turn off this layer group, you can see how it looks as if it was screen printed. And now you get the two options of the design to pick from. So if you want it to look like as if screen printed onto the jersey, you could do that with the base shirt design here in the main jersey. And if you want it to look like as if it's a patch that goes on top of the jersey, you could just turn on this layer group. Gotta get it looking like this. This also applies to the captain badge here. You can see how it looks like it's kind of popping off the jersey as if it's a 3D layer that's on top of the jersey. One last thing we can do is change the background layer. So if you go to BG background here, click the background color and let's pick this green, then change the background text to Dallas Stars. Let's make it a little bit bigger. All right, so that's pretty much it for the making of this tutorial on how to do the Dallas Stars jersey using our new Hockey Adizero jersey template. This template comes in 8K resolution, so if you zoom in you can see all these details, which should help you present your templates as realistic as possible. Hope you guys like this template. Looking forward to see what you guys are gonna make with it. Don't forget to follow us on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and see you guys on the next one.